over to Brown Mountain, we are taking the dual engine go-kart off-roading. Now, this is the place that me and Penny Pincher went to around a year ago, and this is only the second time I've ever been there, so I kind of know what to expect, and I'm not entirely sure how well the dual engine go-kart's gonna do on these off-roading trails, just because I will admit it's a little underpowered, so I don't know. I'm hoping it does well. Hoping it doesn't break down in the middle of the trail, just because that would suck. So anyway, we're just gonna take this thing off-road and see what this thing does. Hopefully it don't break down.
Thank you. Well, we got our first breakdown. This came off. It looks like this is hitting this. It's going, the suspension is moving so much that it's hitting that, because it used to look like that one. Now it's like that. So this like totally bent all the way up, and it actually broke this. That's hot. Muffler's hot. It actually broke the spark plug boot. So now, that muffler's hot. Stop touching it. So that's broken now. That's great. Not really sure how I'm going to put that back on, because a screw came out. I forgot to thread lock it. Yeah, that's good. Awesome. Broken down. Chain's a bit loose. That one's not too bad. And that one's fine. This thing's, it's fine. Thank you.
as good as there is to.
Just got back and finished strapping this thing down. Now, I gotta say, I'm actually really impressed with how this thing performed. Now, there are some issues. There are some changes that I'd like to do. Definitely need to stiffen up the rear suspension. Not really sure how I would do that. Definitely need to stiffen up the front suspension, but mainly it's the rear, just because it kept bottoming out at the end of all those jumps. So, or I guess those are jumps or whatever those things are. But other issues like this air filter relocator, not really sure what else you'd call it. This kept hitting up here just because this is when the suspension bottomed out. It would slam into this. You can see the paint's marked off. You can see it totally bent it up. That's how it used to look, and then that's how it looks now. So that is an issue I gotta fix. And also this engine just kept having issues with running, kept dying, kept backfiring. Really didn't want to idle. I kept having to turn the idle up to where it was actually constantly pushing the engine, and every time I'd stop, it would start burning the belt. Otherwise, if I turned the idle down a little bit, it would just constantly keep dying. So another issue we were having is this. You can see this is totally bashed in. It kept hitting the shock right there. That's how it's supposed to look. I guess you can see it. And that's how this looked. This totally got smashed in to where I didn't have electric start with this engine, because that just totally smashed up against the starter gear, whatever the thing's called. So that's also an issue that this thing's having. Other than that, this thing works pretty well. Now let's finish loading this thing up. Let's get the heck out of here. All right, let's go. Thinking about selling this thing, just because I say it all the time that I need to sell these and I never end up doing it, and I think it's about time to sell one of these things. So if I am selling it, by the time I upload this video, I'll be posting a link in the description below to where you guys can find the ad on Craigslist for this thing. If you don't see the link, I haven't sold it yet. I may want to save it. Me and Redbeard have been talking about doing more off-roading collaborations, and I may want to save this thing for that. But if there is the link for the ad, that I am selling this. I'm not sure how much it's gonna be. If you're in the North Carolina area and you want to buy this thing, definitely check the ad out. But anyway, I gotta end this video here. Thank y'all for watching. I'll see ya in the next video.
And there's a famous re-get-upper.
Yeah.
Does it?
Yeah, it's pretty fun.
two engines, which I kind of wouldn't recommend just because one is always going to be running stronger than the other.
Yeah.
And it's kind of a nightmare to tune them, but it works. It's a lot of fun. Yeah.
What size of engines are they?
Tillotson 212. They're like a Predator, just better.
Right.
Yeah. When I modded them out, they're stage three, so they're producing around 18 horsepower each, I think. So, yeah, a lot of fun. How much have I spent on it, or how much is it for sale?
Did you build it?
Built it from scratch.
Nice.
Yeah. No, it costs a lot.
Yeah.
I'd say I put about maybe $2,500 into this thing. $3,000 maybe. Yeah. But it's a lot of fun.
You don't have enough trouble up there, huh?
Yeah, I was having some trouble with that. It kept hitting this because the suspension moves up and down so much. It kept hitting that and kept knocking it off. But other than that, everything worked great. Yeah.
All right, man.
All right. Thanks. There's some guy staring at me like, what the heck is he doing? He's talking to himself. He's crazy. Yep, I'm just gonna pretend like I'm on the phone or something. I don't know. Talking to a camera. Oh, I hate doing outros in public. Yeah, I was wondering why my steering was getting loose. Yeah, that's a problem. Oh, I gotta fix that. Oh boy.